Folks, I'm Tom Peterson here, and I'm proud to do a video presentation for you this morning on this really, really excellent condition 2016 Jayco. It's the Jay Feather Series 7, so it's narrower, really ultra light, tows beautifully, is in, again, really excellent condition. It's a model 16 XRB, so it's got the hybrid cloth on it and the vinyl coating over it. And so what you've got is you've got your front main bed here, and then you're going to also have one in the back. And what's unique about this hybrid design is that you can leave them in and still kind of make beds out there if you're into real cold weather all of a sudden. You can really be versatile in the sense of bringing those in and still having the walls still made out of the same material as the exterior sides of them. And so it means you still have all that insulation value if you wanted to. Also, if you're going someplace, you can just have one or the other bed open in the back or front too. So a lot of versatility that the hybrids offer out there, unlike the tent tritter itself, where you have to fold all that up, and then of course when you're done, being able to the effort to get it back out open again and have it dry out and everything on those tent tritters are a little bit different than this hybrid, because these are on a cable system. So what you'll see on the inside anyway is there's a cable that runs on both sides, so when you flip this down, it's very easy to open it and close it up again if you need to. So when you're done camping, close it in, get home, open it back up again, let it dry out pretty quickly. It's easy, doesn't take a lot of effort. And also too, with a hybrid, you can also get in and load and unload that trailer when you are, unlike a tent trailer, when you're ready to go on your trip, because when these are all up and folded up, they don't take up any space inside the home. So again, we'll show you that stuff on the inside, but we'll start on the outside and then we'll finish up that way. You'll see it does have the nice big power awning. So it's about as big as one as you can get on a 16-foot trailer. So it has that. You've also got laminated sidewalls that are vacuum laminated, that Jayco does a great job of curing those and making sure that they get an excellent seal by having those sit indoors for a while when they're getting them laminated. You do have an outside grill, looks like, that will mount on this bracket you see here. You're also going to have a place for maybe an exterior TV that you can take from the inside and place it outside if you wanted to as well. And you're going to have your cable and your power supply. It does have nice custom wheels on there, which make it look good. It's got the double entry step, so it's easy to get in and out. It does have a little shock holding that that door open there, so you can also release that if you didn't want it to have more versatility on that if you needed to. Again, the vinyl coated canvas that you're going to have all the way on around makes it very nice and for cleaning and maintaining down the road. You are going to have rear jacks on here for stabilization, the outside spare tire, makes it nice. You do have your supply cord here, about 25 foot long. That'll be where your supply is. You do have black tank flush, and also you're also going to have your cable hook up here, and then your outside shower for hot and cold, city water connection, and then your fill for your fresh water tank. And then you've got your double tanks up front and room for the battery you see over there. We're gonna make sure the battery is in good working order for you and fill those propane tanks up. And then you got a power tongue jack with a light on it as well too, to help you when you're hooking up. Let's go on the inside and we'll show you how nice and versatile that interior space is. We'll start up here, and you see what we've got is the main bed up here is gonna be a large one. So it's going to be at least 60 wide, and you're probably going to have if it's not a full 80, it's probably going to be 75 inches as far as your length goes. So nice big bed up here. You also have the booth dinette that can make down into a bed. This table's portable, so you can take the table outside and have that out under your awning, which makes it nice and versatile as well. And then your couch makes into a quick bed, or you've got seating here, so you've got three, and then you can sit, so you can have as many as seven people kind of comfortably in here, entertaining if the weather is really bad outside. And then one nice feature too with both of these beds, this one and the one in the back I'll show you, this pad is heated, so that way you can kind of have it hooked up, and when you're hooked up to power, be able to have nice electric blankets on both of the beds. We'll switch with the camera, and you can kind of see some of that inside space over there. He'll show you some of that, and then also up above here, so there is good storage, which is going to end up being all the way through there. And then you're also going to have one in here. That'll be a nice storage area. And then there is storage accessed on the outside I showed you under that couch. And the way that the setup here is with the TV is that you can release this and move that to where you want it to be at. You also have a place that looks like a little CD player there. Oh, maybe not. I don't want to say what that is there. We'll have to find out what that player is there for you. And then behind it does have the air conditioner on the side mount that way, so it's easy to ever replace and deal with. And it's a very small trailer. It doesn't take much to cool it down. And then your big window there that opens up. Refrigerator's up high, so you are going to have this little flip down freezer section there. And then there, it's a little bit smaller, but it's nice for a good size. Yeah, I've seen some of these trailers where it's under the counter. It's a real tiny little fridge, so it's nice to have a bigger one up there. You do have the two burner stove, and of course your hot and cold water there for your sink. And you're going to see some storage that's down below there, which is really nice actually. That's real good to have that much. And then the counter space on there for food prep and everything's very nice as well too. I'll go ahead and open up this. You can see how big the bathroom is. Got a nice little corner shower, and you got your sink and a little medicine cabinet and a skylight above. That's a lot of natural light through there, makes it easier. Again, it's only 7 wide, so it's putting in quite a bit of space for a smaller unit. I'll step out and let the camera guy show you that bed back there. Of course, it's going to show you it's still a big bed. It's at least a double. Might even be a what's called an RV queen size as well too. And of course, again, the canvas is all, you can unzip all of the sides and the ends on these beds to create a lot of airflow with that mesh, because you keep the bugs out, but you can get all that fresh air coming through. And that's the beauty of having a hybrid trailer, is that you end up getting that real feeling of camping and being out in that area like you almost in a tent, but being able to still seal everything off and have a lot of warmth from the furnace and all the things you can do inside here. So it's, again, a very, very versatile setup that you can use. So if you have any questions at the end of the video, you'll have my number that will appear, Tom Peterson, 541-521-3642. And get a hold of me anytime. Been doing a long time and have some pretty good knowledge. So if there's anything that we didn't cover in this little brief video, you'll be able to ask me questions, and you can text me anytime as well too at that number. Again, have a great time, and we'll talk to you soon.